you about a couple things today. Back buttering tiles. I did make a short video yesterday about tiles that weren't properly set or back buttered, and they were literally popping right off the floor. So a lot of guys don't believe in back buttering. I personally do, especially with larger format tiles. It's very important that you get maximum coverage with your thin set on the back of your tile so that you have a successful floor. That if you drop something on it, you don't have hollow spots in it and you won't break your tiles. So a couple things, trowel selection is always key. This is the one I normally use. It's a bit of a different notch, but this would be more of a traditional type of trowel. If you're using this as a 3/8 notch, and if you're going to use this on larger format tiles, typically what you need to do is put this on the floor and back butter the tile with this notch as well. This puts down a lot more mud. I'll show you up close here in a minute. But typically you can do this on the floor and then just do a skim coat for bond on the back of the tile. But a couple things. This will be geared more for the do-it-yourselfer, someone maybe wanting to set tile in their house. If you're a professional, you should already know this information. Or if you don't, hopefully it helps. So first thing is when you trowel your mud on the floor, mixing your mud the right consistency is always key as well. Don't make it too thin. Then your lines, your ridges from your trowel won't stand up the way that you want them to. And if you make it too thick, with the porcelain especially, it's hard to get a correct bond on the back of that tile if the mud's not at the right consistency. First thing is when you trowel your mud on the floor, you always want to make sure that it's troweled in a straight direction all one way. I see a lot of guys all the time, even professionals for that matter, they swirl it, which it would be this way. With the swirls in there, what happens when you compress that tile in there, it gives nowhere for the air to escape, so you don't get hardly any bond when you swirl, and it's just easier to apply that way, which is why typically why people do it, because it's easier than going straight. But don't ever swirl this way. You always want to go straight this way or straight this way. Either way you go, make it sure it's all straight, combed evenly. Don't let your trowel lift up on you. So first thing I'm going to do, I got a few tiles here. I'm going to trowel this down real quick. Straight line. without a back butter. And then smash it in like the last one. I'm gonna pop this one up and take a look at it. See, it's a little harder to get off the floor than the other. And you can see, you got a lot more bond out of that one, but you still have bare spots that you don't want. It's not completely covered on the back of that tile. Porcelain tiles, larger format tiles, natural stone, you want 95 to 100% coverage on the back of that tile when you lift it up like that. So that one was better, but it's still not where you want to be. So that you have a good, successful installation, and you have a floor that will never fail. That's really the key. And another thing, with porcelain tiles, especially with porcelain, because porcelain tiles don't absorb water, if you're cutting porcelain on a wet saw, you need to have a towel or something so that when you bring that tile back from the saw, you need to dry that off really good. That water, if you leave that water on there, it'll form a barrier between the tile and the mortar, and it will not bond at all. Probably what happened in the other room is they didn't dry their cuts off, and they just set them. But one can only speculate. But I'm going to get this tile wet, put it in there, and show you what it does on the back when you get them wet. So if you're using a wet saw and your tile gets wet, very important that you dry that off. That tile is soaked with water. You put this in there, you can smash it down all you want. You come back, pop that up, you have zero. You will not let that mud bond if that tile is wet. It doesn't matter how many times you try to do it. Until you dry that tile off, it's just going to, it forms a shield between that. That water forms a barrier between the tile and the mortar on the floor, and it won't bond. So very, very important, if you're using a wet saw, setting porcelain or any other tile for that matter, you need to make sure that surface area is dry before you place it into the thin set. So I'm going to go ahead and let this run for a minute. Also about lippage. You want to avoid lippage in the floor. You need to do everything you can to not have lips in it. Build up your thin set. If your floor is too deep, you know, if you get over a certain depth, you want to use a self-leveling compound. You don't want to have your thin set like super, super deep. It's not made to do that. There's a lot of different ways to deal with that. This is that spot right here that was a little low. So I'm going to put a little bit more mud right there. I'm going to go ahead and reset this one. And you want to really work that down in there. See, I've still got a lip. You always carry a bucket and a sponge with you when you're setting tile, so that you can clean this mess up as you go. Taking these in and out of this mud right here just created a big mess. You don't normally have that much, but clean it as you go. Try to keep your joints cleaned out. You have minimal prep when you come back to grout. You don't have to go around and scratch all the thin set out of the joints. Now right here, I've got a lip. You probably can't see it from there. This end's a little high, which I know I can just push that down. But I'm going to come back with my margin trowel. This end's a little low. I'm going to go ahead and pop that up. Just lift it up a little bit. I'm going to put a little bit of extra mud on this end right here that was low. You don't want to get too much under there because it's too hard to keep working it down, smashing it out. But after you do this for a while, you can judge how much mortar you need to put on the floor to compensate for that lip. And then right there, if it feels like it's not hard to push down in there and get it even to where you want it, then you know you don't have enough mud. Another thing you can do is if you're worried about this edge getting broke, take your margin trowel. Just stuff a little mud underneath that edge right there. That'll pack that edge real nice for you. If anything ever gets dropped on the edge of a tile, it won't fracture. That's not necessary, but it is. It does work good to pack mud underneath that very edge so that you don't ever have to worry about it cracking. Just extra assurance is all that is. Better safe than sorry. Then you want to just work this tile down in there. The more you rock it back and forth like that, the more you're distributing that thin set on the back of that tile back there. Sometimes you really got to push on it. And you want to get it to where you don't have any lips. You can also use a mallet. If it gets a little too hard, push down on it, hit it, it'll work it down in there for you. It just takes a little patience and a little work. Just keep sawing that back and forth like that, and it'll work that thin set down in there. After a few minutes, get it right where you want it. So now here I've got no lip, no lip, no lip. That's what you're looking for. I usually use a 2 foot, 4 foot level, sometimes a 6 foot level, depends on the floor, but lay that down there and make sure you're flat here. You can get another look if you have a gap. If you're riding high over here, you can go ahead and manipulate that tile with that thin set under there and get it perfectly flat. Especially with these, when they use bigger baseboards, you want your floor to be flat. Otherwise, you're going to see a big gap underneath your tile. It doesn't look good. We typically use a level all the way across our floor. Make sure it's completely level this way, this way. That's just the way we do it. We do work on a lot of really high-end jobs, so level's always key with the doors, with the base. Just makes everything a lot easier for everybody. and your floor looks a lot better when you're finished. So hopefully that helped out. Just wanted to make a quick informational video about lippage and how to properly set a tile. So see you on the next one.